quick revision of what we learned yesterday. We learned that there are totally five heads of accounting. That is asset, liability, capital, expenses, and revenue. In olden days, they used to be real, personal, nominal, but now they are asset, liability, capital, and capital, expenses, and revenue. And yesterday, we learned that what all comes under asset, what all comes under liability, capital, expense, revenue. Okay, so even this will be also useful to you in 6 mark section, where they will ask, classify the following account into five heads hota hai, to uske liye bhi aapko use hoga. Okay, then to aaj hum in detail check karenge ki kaise journal entries पास किया जाता है. आदित्य, कैन यू हियर मी?
हाँ हाँ
यस. एनीवन हु लाइक टू बी पार्ट ऑफ इट, पार्ट ऑफ द डिस्कशन, कैन रेज हैंड्स. ओके, सो नोबडी हैज रेज देयर हैंड्स. ओके, अनमोल इज देयर. अनमोल, कैन यू हियर मी? Can you hear me, Anmol? Now you are unmuted. Okay. So let's begin. Somesh is there. Somesh, can you hear me, Somesh?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So let's start with the two students. Anmol, I am unmuting you, but I don't know what's the problem with you. Okay. So, Somesh, did you attend yesterday's class?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So, now these are the rules for assets, expenses, liability, capital, and revenue, which we discussed at the end yesterday. So, if it is an asset or expense, then it has to, like, increase in that particular thing will be debited and decrease will be credited. And when it comes to liability, capital, and revenue, again, like here it will be opposite. Increase will be credited and decrease will be debited. Okay. Now,
yes, sir.
Let's start. First, this is a common journal entry which you will be seeing in your examination as well as in your textbook. That is, started business with cash. Started business with cash. Okay. It may be of any amount. Let us consider that it is 1 lakh. Done?
Yes.
Now, what happens in this case? Let us try to understand. When the business is started with cash. Okay. You tell me, before the proprietor introduces cash, whether business was having any money with it?
No, sir.
No. Okay. So that means when the proprietor brings cash into the business, the cash will increase. Do you agree?
Yes.
Here plus what I am writing, that in that indicates increase. Okay.
Yes.
And there is another thing involved. See, when the proprietor brings money to the business, it becomes the duty of the business to give that back to the proprietor.
Yes.
Why? Because we consider business and owner to be two separate entities. You remember separate entity concept, which says, for accounting purpose, we consider that owner and business are the two separate entities.
Two different countries.
Right?
Yes.
Okay. So now let's consider. So the amount of liability which you need to pay back to the owner, that is called as capital, that also increases. I agree, money is coming into the business, but remember that need to be paid back. So cash is also increasing, even capital is also increasing. So for this reason, what I do is I write cash account debit. Why? Because cash is an asset. Do you agree? Cash is an asset.
Asset.
See, yesterday we mentioned here, cash is an asset and the rule of asset applies. So what is rule of asset? Increase should be debited, right?
Debit.
Okay, next. What is capital rule? The increase should be credited. So here I write, to capital account. Remember, always this to should be written by giving some space. Okay. So I write cash account debit to capital account. And in the amount column, I will be writing 1 lakh and one. Sorry. 1 lakh and 1 lakh. Did you understand?
Yes.
So now, in brackets, I will write being started business with cash. What is this? This is called as narration. What we call it as?
Narration.
Narration. What is narration? Narration is the brief explanation of the journal entry. I hope you have understood.
Yes, sir.
Narration is the brief explanation of the journal entry. Are you clear? So once this is done, you need to close the particular column only. Remember, the line should be drawn only in only for particular column, and no other column should be closed. Did you understand?
Yes, sir.
Now, if we write the date here, we will be writing date also. Okay. So what is better is if all the transactions belong to a particular date, it's better you log that date and year in the beginning only. Beginning mein kya karna, usko log kar dena taki problem na ho, usko har bar likhne ki zarurat nahi padti. So now here you can just write 4. Okay. Next, let us take another example. See, I will try to cover all the journal entries, what all he can ask. So now what happens? Started business with cash rupees 1 lakh and he says machinery rupees 2 lakh. You are able to understand?
Yes.
That means with how many assets he is going to start? He is going to start with 2 assets. Okay. So that's why yesterday while explaining, I said capital is not just money. Even it can be money's worth. That means he can bring stock, he can bring asset as capital. Okay. So now, what is happening here? In the earlier case, what was happening? Cash was increasing. Can you see here?
Yes.
Now machinery will also increase, because when he brings machinery, the machinery will also increase. Okay. And capital will also increase. So that means, try to understand, this cash and machinery are asset and increase in them should be debited, because just now we saw the rule. Cash asset ka rule kya tha? Increase should be debited. So in this case, what I will do, I will just write here machinery account debit. You are able to understand? Machinery account debit. And here I write 2 lakhs. And now the total capital will not be 1 lakh. It will be 3 lakh. That is cash.
3 lakh.
That is cash 1 lakh. And machinery 2 lakh. So what is the total capital? That is 3 lakh. I hope you have understood this.
Yes, sir.
Pakka?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So Aditya, tell the dido.
Yes, sir.
Okay. Now, so next. So this is the second thing. Ultimately, what we need to remember is if an asset increases, it should be debited, and if a liability or capital increases, it should be credited. Now, next is, I will further add to this journal entry, that is, started business with rupees, one cash rupees 1 lakh, machinery rupees 2 lakh, and bank loan rupees 50,000. Okay, Aditya. Hey Aditya, cash le dela. हाँ एक मात्रा नोड़ा में
हाँ क्या इसलिए
एक बैंक लोन है ना दला राइट है इधर ना मग असेट एक्ट दला लायबिलिटी एक्ट दला एक ने नो बैंक लोन इड़ता दिला हेलो
सर
एक
हेलो
हाँ बैंक लोन ये नक्कत रहा सेट एक्ट लायबिलिटी एक्ट तो
लायबिलिटी
याक लायबिलिटी याक एक्ट थे लो लायबिलिटी लायबिलिटी अंदर ये है लो जवाबदारी हो दिला
हाँ
नी बैंक ना लोन तो कौन दे अंदर अदन वापिस कोड़ जवाबदारी अदेल ने का
हाँ
अद का दे नक्कत द लायबिलिटी एक्ट था तो क्लियर
हाँ
पक्का
हाँ
ओके डन ओके सो अभी देखो नो व्हाट विल बी द चेंज नाउ लायबिलिटी रूल है ना आदित्य है नो 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 इलेज़न उड़ेगा ये ना द लायबिलिटी रूल है लो What is
debit
the rule for
decrease act?
Huh?
Debit decrease act.
Huh?
Credit increase act.
Okay. Ega loan tondi vandra liability hechayito kammayito.
In case.
Ninu loan tondi andra liability hechaktado kadime aktado. लोन तो कौन रहे कड़ी आता था ए सोमेश बराबर है कह रहे हैं हेच आता था लापे
हाँ सर
लायबिलिटी हेच आता रही है नक्कत है लापे क्रेडिट मारते हो डेबिट मारते हो
क्रेडिट सर
हाँ या का क्रेडिट या क मारती है ड्री रूल है तो
सर इट इज़ द रूल ऑफ़
लायबिलिटी शुड बी क्रेडिटेड करेक्ट आ See, this yes, is how the yes, journal sir. Entry looks like. Total assets yesterday, 1 lakh plus 2 lakh. Total assets is to 3 lakh. Correct?
3 lakh.
A 3 lakh naga bank loan yesterday, 50,000. Andre, nan 3 lakh rupai asset naga, 50,000 rupai yena pandre, bank le loan to kondidada. Andre, nee swantha ke droka yesterday to 2 lakh 50,000. That is called as capital.
Capital.
Okay. So here it will be the formula what we use is capital is equal to asset minus
liability.
Clear? Next. So this kind of entries may appear in your examination. So next. Leave this. Next. Next journal entry. Next transaction is deposited cash into bank. Deposited cash into bank. Okay. How much? Rupees 10,000. Okay. Otherwise, we will deposit more. 50,000 we will deposit. Now, so what happens when we deposit cash into bank? Let us try to understand. Anybody? AP, Aditya.
Huh?
If I deposit cash, nanbali cash, nanbali cash ada, nadan vai del haklikatini bank naga. Correct?
Bank.
Ega nanbali rokka idid kam aktavo jasti aktavo na bank naga hakidnanta. Nanbali cash ididu. Cash kam aktadu jasti aktadu.
Kam aktadu.
ಕ್ಯಾಶ್ ಕಮ್ ಆಗ್ತದ ಬ್ಯಾಂಕ್ ನಾಗ ರೊಕ್ಕ ಏನಾಗ್ತಾವ ಜಾಸ್ತಿ ಆಗ್ತಾವ ಕಮ್ ಆಗ್ತಾವ
ಜಾಸ್ತಿ ಆಗ್ತಾವ
ಅಂದ್ರ ಬ್ಯಾಂಕ್ ಬ್ಯಾಲೆನ್ಸ್ ಹೆಚ್ಚಾಗ್ಲಿಕ್ಕದ ಕ್ಯಾಶ್ ಬ್ಯಾಲೆನ್ಸ್ ಕಮ್ ಆಗ್ಲಿಕ್ಕದ ಕರೆಕ್ಟ್ ಆಯ್ತಾ ಓಕೆ ಸೊ ಬ್ಯಾಂಕ್ ನು ನನ್ನ ಪಾಲಿಗೆ ಅಸೆಟ್ ಕ್ಯಾಶ್ ನು ನನ್ನ ಪಾಲಿಗೆ ಅಸೆಟ್ ಓಕೆ ಬಿಕಾಸ್ ಎರಡ್ರಾಗ್ನು ರೊಕ್ಕನೇ ಅವ ಕ್ಯಾಶ್ ನಂದೇ ಅದ ಕ್ಯಾಶ್ ಅದ್ಲ ಬ್ಯಾಂಕ್ ನಾಗ ಇಟ್ರು ಅದ್ನು ನಂದೇ ಓಕೆ ಅಸೆಟ್ ರೂಲ್ ಏನ್ ಹೇಳ್ತದ ಯಾವ್ದು ಇನ್ಕ್ರೀಸ್ ಆಗ್ತದ ಅದು ಡೆಬಿಟ್ ಮಾಡು ಯಾವ್ದು ಡಿಕ್ರೀಸ್ ಆಗ್ತದ ಅದು ಕ್ರೆಡಿಟ್ ಮಾಡು ಕರೆಕ್ಟ್ ಅದನ್ನ ಸೊ ನಾ ಇಲ್ಲಿ ಏನ್ ಬರೀತೀನಿ ಬ್ಯಾಂಕ್ ಅಕೌಂಟ್ ಡೆಬಿಟ್ ಕ್ಲಿಯರ್ ಬ್ಯಾಂಕ್ ಅಕೌಂಟ್
ಡೆಬಿಟ್
ಡೆಬಿಟ್ ಯಾಕ ಬಿಕಾಸ್ ದೇರ್ ಇಸ್ ಅ ಇನ್ಕ್ರೀಸ್ ಇನ್ ಬ್ಯಾಂಕ್ ಬ್ಯಾಲೆನ್ಸ್
ಬ್ಯಾಂಕ್
ಟೂ ಕ್ಯಾಶ್ ಅಕೌಂಟ್ ಎದಕ್ಕ Because cash balance has decreased. Okay. So now, I will write a brief explanation of the journal entry that is being deposited cash into bank. Did you understand? Tiyodadri?
Hi.
Akash, go together. Raise your hands. If you have understood, you can raise your hands. Okay. Good. Vijay, Nachiket, done. So being deposited cash into bank. Next. After that. Now let us look at purchase journal entries. What happens when you purchase? Now, first type of purchase is purchased goods for cash. ₹10,000 ಅದಿತ್ಯ ಏನದ ಟ್ರಾನ್ಸಾಕ್ಷನ್ ಓದು ಒಂದ್ಸಲ
ಪರ್ಚೇಸ್ ಗೂಡ್ಸ್ ಫಾರ್ ಕ್ಯಾಶ್ ₹10,000
ಈಗ ನೋಡು ನಿನ್ನೆ ಹೇಳಿದ್ದೆ ನಾನು ರೆವಿನ್ಯೂ ಅರ್ನ್ ಮಾಡ್ಲಿಕ್ಕೆ ಏನೇ ದುಡ್ಡು ನಾವು ಖರ್ಚು ಮಾಡಿದ್ರು ಅದಕ್ಕೆ ನಾವೇನಂತೀವಿ ಎಕ್ಸ್ಪೆನ್ಸಸ್ ಅಂತೀವಿ ನಾ ಪರ್ಚೇಸ್ ಯಾಕೆ ಮಾಡ್ತೀನಿ ನನಗ್ ಸೇಲ್ ಮಾಡೋದಂತೆ ಪರ್ಚೇಸ್ ಮಾಡ್ತೀನ ನಾನು then purchase is a expenses jilita purchase is a expenses
expense
and purchase expenses adala a expense maadde andre rokka kadi magtavo jaast aagtav ni enana kharidi madidru ninbal rokka kadi magtavo jaast aagtav
kadi mag
rokka kadi magtav hodilla so andre cash balance is decreasing ಈಗ ಎಕ್ಸ್ಪೆನ್ಸಸ್ ರೂಲ್ ಏನ್ ಹೇಳ್ತದ ನೋಡು ಆ ರೂಲ್ ನಿನ್ ಹತ್ರ ಬರ್ದಿದ್ದೆ ಯಾವಾಗ್ಲೂ ತೆಗೆದಿಟ್ಕೋ ರೂಲ್ ಏನ್ ಹೇಳ್ತದ ನೋಡು ಎಕ್ಸ್ಪೆನ್ಸಸ್ ಎಲ್ಲರೂ ನೋಡ್ರಿ ಎಕ್ಸ್ಪೆನ್ಸಸ್ ರೂಲ್ ಏನ್ ಹೇಳ್ತದ್ರಿ
ಇನ್ಕ್ರೀಸ್ ಇನ್ ಎಕ್ಸ್ಪೆನ್ಸಸ್ ಶುಡ್ ಬಿ ಡೆಬಿಟೆಡ್ ಸರ್
ಇನ್ಕ್ರೀಸ್ ಇನ್ ಎಕ್ಸ್ಪೆನ್ಸಸ್ ಶುಡ್ ಬಿ ಡೆಬಿಟೆಡ್ ಕರೆಕ್ಟ್ ಸೊ ಈಗ ಯಾವ ಎಕ್ಸ್ಪೆನ್ಸ್ ಡೆಬಿಟ್ ಮಾಡ್ಬೇಕು ನಾನು purchases account should be debited correct
yes
then I will write to cash account yakandre cash balance decrease aitu
yes
right so yes, 10,000 and 10,000 so what I will write here being goods purchased for cash tilita
yes sir
pakka
yes sir
tilitilo aditya
ha theek
ei nadu nodu answer madu ombagane omme disappear aagtid ninu aita ek ha purchased goods for cash ₹10,000 aitu okay next purchased goods from Mr. Puneet. Mr. Puneet, rupees 10,000. Okay. हाँ इल्ली यल्लादरु कैश अंत हेळ्यारे नोडप्प
हेळिल्ल
ओके एंड कैश हेळिल्ल एंड प्लस हेसरु कोट्टिद्रु अंत इट्को ओके निंग हिंदी तिळितेना
हां तिळित
हां अगर अगर परचेस किया गया है और कैश बोल के मेंशन नहीं किया गया है और पर्सन का नाम दिया गया है तो याद रखिए दैट विल बी अ क्रेडिट ट्रांजैक्शन अंदर उद्री इरतद अदु एन इरतद उद्री हेळिता ओके सो उद्री अंदर एनु रोक्का कोडोदिल्ल इमीडिएटली सो व्हेन यू परचेस गुड्स अगेन यू आर इनकरिंग एक्सपेंसेस ಇಲ್ಲೇನಾಗಿತ್ತು ಪರ್ಚೇಸ್ ಅಂತೂ ಇನ್ಕರ್ ಆಗ್ಲಿಕ್ಕೆ ಎಕ್ಸ್ಪೆನ್ಸಸ್ ಬಟ್ ಯು ಆರ್ ನಾಟ್ ಪೇಯಿಂಗ್ ಕ್ಯಾಶ್ ಇಮಿಡಿಯೇಟ್ಲಿ ಯು ಆರ್ ಪೋಸ್ಟ್ ಪೋನಿಂಗ್ ದ ಪೇಮೆಂಟ್ ವಾಟ್ ಯು ಆರ್ ಡೂಯಿಂಗ್ ಯು ಆರ್ ಪೋಸ್ಟ್ ಪೋನಿಂಗ್ ದ ಪೇಮೆಂಟ್ ಸೊ ವಾಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಮೀನ್ಡ್ ಬೈ ಪೋಸ್ಟ್ ಪೋನಿಂಗ್ ದ ಪೇಮೆಂಟ್ ಐ ವಿಲ್ ಬಿ ಪೇಯಿಂಗ್ ಇಟ್ ಲೇಟರ್ ರೈಟ್ ಸೊ ಲೇಟರ್ ಮೀನ್ಸ್ ಅವನಿಗೆ ಇನ್ನು ರೊಕ್ಕ ಕೊಡೋದದ ಅನ್ನಂಗ ಐತ್ರಿ ನೀ ಕೊಟ್ಟಿಲ್ಲ ಅಂದ್ರೆ ನಿನಗ್ ರೊಕ್ಕ ಕೊಡು ಜವಾಬ್ದಾರಿ ಅದ ಅಂತ ಮೀನಿಂಗ್ ಕೊಡ್ತದ ಓಕೆ ಸೊ ಆ ರೊಕ್ಕ ಕೊಡು ಜವಾಬ್ದಾರಿ ಅದಂದ್ರೆ ಇಟ್ ಇಸ್ ನಥಿಂಗ್ ಬಟ್ ಲಯಬಿಲಿಟಿ ವಾಟ್ ಇಟ್ ಇಸ್ ಹಾ ಇಟ್ ಇಸ್ ಲಯಬಿಲಿಟಿ ಓಕೆ ಸೊ ಇನ್ಕ್ರೀಸ್ ಇನ್ ಲಯಬಿಲಿಟಿ ನಾವೇನ್ ಮಾಡ್ತೇವೆ ವಿ ಕ್ರೆಡಿಟ್ ಸೊ ಅದಕ್ಕೆ ಇಲ್ಲಿ ಏನ್ ಮಾಡ್ತೀನಿ ಪರ್ಚೇಸ್ ಅಕೌಂಟ್ ಡೆಬಿಟ್ ಟು ಮಿಸ್ಟರ್ ಪುನೀತ್ ಅಕೌಂಟ್ ಅಂತ ಬರೀತೀನಿ ಮಿಸ್ಟರ್ ಪುನೀತ್ ಅಕೌಂಟ್ ಸೊ ವಾಟ್ ಈಸ್ ದಿ ಅಮೌಂಟ್ 10,000 ಇಲ್ಲಿ ನರೇಷನ್ ಸ್ವಲ್ಪ ಚೇಂಜ್ ಮಾಡಬೇಕಾಗ್ತದೆ ಬೀಯಿಂಗ್ ಗೂಡ್ಸ್ ಪರ್ಚೇಸ್ಡ್ ಆನ್ ಕ್ರೆಡಿಟ್ ತಿಳಿತಾ
ಎಸ್ ಸರ್
ಬೀಯಿಂಗ್ ಗೂಡ್ಸ್ ಪರ್ಚೇಸ್ಡ್ ಆನ್ ಕ್ರೆಡಿಟ್ Next. Moving ahead. Now I will change the transaction again. Purchased goods. Even purchased goods from Tagada Burtini. Purchased machinery. From or purchased machinery for rupees 20,000. So machinery next khareedi maadi appa nenu
20,000.
Ha. So machinery nanage enu machinery is asset.
Asset.
Ha. Machinery is asset. Do you agree? Machinery is an asset.
Asset.
Right.
Yes, sir.
So when the machinery is bought, that asset. Means an asset will increase in the business. Okay.
Yes.
So when the asset increases in the business, certainly it has to be debited. So I write
debit.
Machinery account debit. Okay. Machinery account debit. Now, when you purchase machinery, what you will pay? You will pay cash.
Cash.
You'll pay cash. And when you pay cash, the cash balance will decrease. And when the cash balance decreases, the cash will be credited because the decrease in cash balance will be credited. Okay. So, hope you have understood.
Yes.
You know, I don't know the exam, like even journal entry, repeat actor. Okay. So, purchased machinery for rupees 20,000, the journal entry will be machinery account debit to cash account. Okay. So now question Bharatat sir, when goods are purchased, you are using purchase and when machinery is purchased, you are using machinery. Why? Because when goods are purchased, remember goods account is classified. Goods account is classified or in accounts, the goods account is classified into four accounts. One is purchase. Next is sales. Next is purchase returns. The next is sales returns. Done?
Yes.
So into these four heads, the goods account has been divided. So when you purchase, you will be using the purchasers. When the goods go out, that is sales, we will be using sales. When the purchased goods are returned, we'll be using purchase returns. And when the sold goods are returned by customers, then we will be using sales returns. Are you clear?
Yes, sir.
So that's why when machinery is purchased, we cannot use purchases, because purchases will be only used when we purchase goods, because goods account is represented by four accounts in accounting. Now, next. So I will slightly change this. Purchased machinery from Raj for rupees 30,000. For what value you have purchased? 20,000. And from Raj. See, the moment name appears in the transaction, yavaga one transaction nag hesaru bantalre, you should be very alert. Ali cash ant mention madane nodbekri. Elladru cash ant mention madane nodre?
Ill madil.
Madilla. So ma cash ant mention madilla andre adu ya transaction irtudre? Credit transaction. Andre enre udre.
Udre.
So if it is credit transaction, then the amount should be paid back. Remember, the amount should be paid back.
Back.
Okay. So paid back means liability. I repeat many times in the class that payable is a liability and receivable is an asset. Do you remember?
Yes, sir.
Payable is a liability. So what is the name of that liability? Machinery account debit to Raj account.
Raj.
What is Raj here? Raj is an increase in liability. Are you clear?
Yes, sir.
Raj is an increase in liability. So journal entry will be machinery account debit to Raj account. What is the meaning of this? There is an increase in machinery and as well as there is an increase in liability. So what narration I will write? Being
purchase of machinery on credit.
Machine purchased on credit.
Credit.
Being machine purchased on credit. I hope you have understood.
Yes, sir.
Next. Okay, so let's move to the sales part. Now, sales. So, there will be normally a transaction which will be given in your examination, that is cash sales. Kya hota hai? Cash sales. The moment cash, you hear cash sales, aapke dimag mein aega kya cash ko hi becha ja raha hai? Nahin. Yaad rakho. It means that the goods are sold and the amount is immediately received. Ye meaning deta hai. Matlab, humne cash ko, goods ko becha aur immediately paisa mila. Clear hai ye baat?
Yes, sir.
To bataiye isme kya ho raha hai? When we sell goods for cash, we will receive the cash. That means the cash is increasing in the business.
Yes, sir.
And when we sell, what is sale? Sale is revenue. Sale is revenue.
Revenue.
And even the revenue is also increasing. The revenue is also increasing. So okay. That's why I have written here plus. So just check when the revenue increases, what we will do? We will debit or credit? Rules ko check karo.
Credit, sir.
Credit.
Credit. Okay. So first I will write cash account debit.
Credit. Debit.
Okay. Then I write to sales account. Why sales account? Because
sales should be debit, credited, sir.
It should be credited because there is an increase in revenue. Okay. So the amount is 5,000 and 5,000. I hope you have understood.
Yes, sir.
Yes.
Pakka?
Yes, sir.
Cash sales. Okay. Sometimes they may give like this. Sold goods to Mustafa. Sold goods to Mustafa. Rupees 5,000. Okay, so Mustafa ko kitne ka beche hai hum log?
5,000.
Haan, what is the value? 5,000.
5,000.
Okay, 5,000. Right. So when we sell goods worth rupees 5,000, whether it is mentioned that cash has been received?
No, sir.
No, it has not been received. Zabi, bata rahe udhar cash bol ke mention kiya gaya kya?
No, sir.
हाँ उधर कैश बोल के है क्या उधर
नहीं
है नहीं है तो जब कैश नहीं दिया गया है और पर्सन का नाम दिया गया है तो सर्टनली वो क्या रहता है क्रेडिट क्या रहता है वो
क्रेडिट
क्रेडिट ओके तो ये ट्रांजैक्शन क्या हो जाता है पहले कैश आया था तो इसीलिए मैंने क्या लिखा कैश अकाउंट डेबिट सही बात है What I wrote, cash account debit, because cash आने वाला था, cash नहीं आने वाला है, पर आपको याद है, पर आपको मालूम होगा कि अब वो पैसा नहीं दिया ना, तो आगे तो देगा ना वो पैसे, हम free में तो नहीं बांट रहे हैं, तो that is called receivable, जो receive नहीं हुआ वो क्या बन जाता है, receivable बन जाता है, सही बात है?
Yes sir.
एंड मैंने अभी अभी कहा था पेएबल अगर लायबिलिटी है तो रिसीवेबल हमारे लिए क्या होगा असेट होगा सही बात है
यस सर
रिसीवेबल इज एन असेट ओके सो व्हेन द क्रेडिट सेल्स इज देयर द रिसीवेबल इज आल्सो एन असेट सो व्हाट इज द नेम ऑफ दैट रिसीवेबल मुस्तफा सो फ्रॉम हुम वी नीड टू रिसीव मनी मुस्तफा तो जर्नल एंट्री क्या बनेगा मुस्तफा अकाउंट डेबिट टू सेल्स ओके समझ में आया व्हाई मुस्तफा अकाउंट इज डेबिटेड बिकॉज मुस्तफा इज अ रिसीवेबल मुस्तफा इज अ रिसीवेबल ओके इंक्रीज इन रिसीवेबल इज नथिंग बट इंक्रीज इन असेट So hence he should be debited. Vijay Tililigati Lepi. Vijo. Vijay.
Yes, sir.
Tililigati Pakka.
Yes, sir.
Okay. So Mustafa Yak Banda hai nodami.
Sir, sold goods to Mustafa.
Mustafa debit hai kada?
Sir, goods only ke debit aa gaya dal sir adike.
Hey, enna ne hetu en magane? Isto tana heli na de.
Sir,
anyone who can explain it? Ene hinda. Ning mute maadi nodu magane hinda avas baalada. Somesh, can you explain why Zabi ya Somesh koi explain karega why Mustafa is debited? हाँ बोल
सर क्योंकि मुस्तफा गुड्स को रिसीव कर रहा है तो वो रिसीवेबल है डेबिट होता है
वेरी गुड रिसीवेबल एक असेट होता है एंड इंक्रीज इन असेट शुड बी डेबिटेड ओके नेक्स्ट सोल्ड गुड्स टू मुस्तफा हो गया तो अभी देखो अब नेक्स्ट Sold machinery. Machinery क्या है हमारे लिए मशीनरी निकाल के फर्नीचर लिख देता हूँ हाँ फर्नीचर हमारे लिए क्या है हाँ वेरी गुड सोल्ड फर्नीचर टू सोल्ड फर्नीचर रुपेश 10,000 मतलब फर्नीचर का वर्थ कितना है 10,000 जिसको हमने बेच ओके तो अब बताओ क्या फर्नीचर गुड्स है? हाँ, फर्नीचर इज एन असेट। तो याद रखो जब वो असेट है तो सेल्स नहीं आएगा, सही बात है? सेल्स कब आता है? जब गुड्स होता है, समझ में आ रहा है?
यस सर।
हाँ, सो व्हेन वी सेल फर्नीचर, यू टेल मी फर्नीचर इज रिड्यूस्ड इन द बिजनेस और इंक्रीज इन द बिजनेस?
रिड्यूस्ड सर।
हाँ, रिड्यूस, दैट मींस फर्नीचर शुड बी क्रेडिटेड। व्हाई? बिकॉज फर्नीचर इज एन असेट एंड डिक्रीज इन फर्नीचर विल बी क्रेडिटेड, बिकॉज असेट का रूल क्या बोलता है? इंक्रीज डेबिट करो और डिक्रीज क्रेडिट करो, सही बात है? Now, जब फर्नीचर हम बेचते हैं, ओके, तो वापस बदले में हमको क्या मिलता है? ए सुमेश बाल गद लिया था पिहिंद। हाँ, बदले में हमको क्या मिलता है? कैश मिलता है,
कैश,
राइट? सो जब कैश मिलता है तो कैश विल इंक्रीज इन द बिजनेस एंड इंक्रीज इन कैश शुड बी डेबिटेड बिकॉज कैश भी एक असेट है। तो एंट्री क्या होगा? कैश अकाउंट डेबिट टू फर्नीचर अकाउंट। आई होप यू हैव अंडरस्टूड। नाउ नेक्स्ट, सो आज के लिए बस इतना, सेल्स तक हम करेंगे, कल बाकी बच्चे जर्नल एंट्रीज करेंगे, राइट? आज के क्लास में कुछ आपको डाउट हो तो आप पूछ सकते हैं, एनीथिंग यू लाइक टू आस्क?
नो सर,
क्योंकि अभी थोड़ी देर के लिए बचा है क्लास, तो अगर आप हैंड्स भी रेस करेंगे तो मैं आपको अलाउ करूंगा पूछने के लिए। ओके, वैष्णवी जाधव हैज अ डाउट। हाँ वैष्णवी।
सर, देयर इज अ जनरल एंट्री कॉल्ड ही सोल्ड गुड,
ही सोल्ड गुड्स,
गुड्स कॉस्टिंग रुपीज 20,000।
He sold goods costing rupees 20,000, huh?
20,000. Then again, close the bracket for rupees 22,000.
Okay. So that does not make any difference while passing journal entry. Wo bracket wala amount hai na, wo costing rupees 20,000, yes. Right? Yes, that sir. Makes difference when you are solving accounting equation problem. Oh. Okay. But it is a journal entry problem. No, see, we are only bothered about sales. So here the journal entry will be cash account debit to sales account, 22,000 and 22,000.
Yes.
Okay.
Okay.
What you have noted down in the book?
So cash account 22,000.